Few video games star arthropods. Usually, if there are arthropods at all, they're the gross monsters you're killing. If you're like me, and you should probably be glad if you're not, you think this is a problem. Aww, sweet little babies. We need more video games about mighty mites and bumbling beetles. One Pico-8 developer, Bridges, apparently agreed. Or not quite, because 8 Legs to Love puts the player in charge of not a mite or insect, but a hungry spider. But there is plenty to love here aside from the 8 legs. The central gameplay is described in this non-interactive tutorial. Yeah, that's what arrow keys tend to do. Eat bugs? Ew. I'll stick to shrimp and crab, thank you very much. So, the player needs to weave webs to catch as many insects as possible. Your web meter at the top of the screen limits the amount of silk you can squeeze from your spinneret. In addition to points, eating bugs refills the web meter. The webs are hardly neat, symmetrical, and beautiful. Your webs will be a tangled mess. Not an elegant one like Charlotte would make, but what works, works. This spider might be small, but she's got big plans! There are 6 stages. Garden, house, bridge, construction, skyscrapers, and world. The spider can't die. If you fall off screen, it'll be teleported back to solid ground. How does the game ever end then? In each stage, there's a hard time limit of 2 minutes 15 seconds. You have the first 45 seconds to build your web before the bugs start buzzing in. If an insect touches a strand of the web, it'll get caught. They wiggle around, giving the spider abundant time to liquefy their insides and suck out the sweet, sweet juice. If you wait too long, your prey will break free of the webbing and buzz away. The impatient, like me, can even catch the bugs when they're not in the web using a well-timed jump. The bugs come in different shapes and colors. Some varieties escape the web more quickly and are worth more points. The most points come from the rainbow bugs. More colorful vegetables tend to be more nutritious, and I guess that carries through to bugs. Though in real life, brightly colored bugs tend to be poisonous? Since this is an arcade-style game, it's all about high scores. Taste those points. Each stage poses a unique challenge. Garden is simple fun to let the player learn the game mechanics, but house adds a pit. There are also these red insects that can hack out of your web if you aren't quick enough. Oops, there one goes. Hack as in cut through and web as in spider web. This isn't cyberpunk. Bridge is where those lovable 8 legs need to really get in gear. At first, I struggled to make a web under the archway without falling into the water in the process. It doesn't kill you, like I said, but it does waste some precious seconds. Then I realized I shouldn't jump, but drag one long strand along as a kind of ground floor for my web. But the bugs will appear both above and beneath the bridge. Adding to the challenge, beginning this stage, bees appear with their sharp, slicing stingers. If you jump to catch them out of the air, they'll repel you. Maybe they're wasps, since those are an enemy of real spiders. The scale of the game changes here, too. Before, the spider was smaller than carrots in framed pictures. Now look how huge it is compared to those trees! If this isn't a miniature model of a bridge, 8 Legs to Love is taking a turn in more ways than just challenge. The construction stage continues the previous trends, with fewer platforms and a lift moving up and down against a city skyline. The spider's grown even larger, and the bugs more dangerous. Given the size of the buildings and construction equipment, the spider is giant. Look at the hard hat. This spider is the size of a human head. Your prey starts hacking away at your web to break free, and there are also these bizarre round bugs that explode like bombs. This evolutionary adaptation doesn't seem like it would increase the odds of reproducing, so I wonder what evolutionary history the bomb bugs might have. Luckily, the spider is plenty fast enough to make sure they don't destroy too much of your handiwork. Or butt work, I guess. In Skyscraper, there can no longer be any doubt 8 Legs to Love depicts a monster movie scenario. The spider and the rest of the bugs are now as large as SUVs. For some continuity of location, we can even see the construction site in which the previous stage took place. Now green bugs fly by, straight out of Galaga, judging from the projectiles they hurl at the spider. But it is all in vain. None can stop us now. The imminent destruction of the world as we know it notwithstanding, Skyscraper is my favorite stage. Here, a strong wind blows the web alternately left and right. Something about seeing the web swing in the breeze between the two clusters of skyscrapers is plain fun, and hopping between the strands, feeling secure in our loose, flowing, spidery home despite the dangerous position high above the ground, it's a great feel. The final stage is World. The increasing size of our eight-legged friend ends on an extreme. Human civilization has obviously crumbled, literally, beneath the spider's 8 legs. Then again, judging by the continents, this might not be Earth. We've come full circle. Galaga gave us bugs in space, and now, here we are. In this stage, the gravity is wonky. The planet pulls the spider in from all sides. Actually, that's gravity working exactly as usual, with nothing wonky whatsoever. I've played this a number of times, but the gravity here is still tough. There might be some trick to it. But this gravity doesn't work with my brain and button-pressing skills. There's also a special seventh stage, sort of. If you simply choose your world number from the stage select, you cannot access it. You have to play through the whole game to see it. That's right. The spider is devouring whole galaxies. I can only assume the spider has eaten so much she is no longer a spider, but a cosmic entity of unfathomable magnitude, God's angel of death destroying millions in seconds. One successful predator, I'd say. She does all this with no malice, for a spider is incapable of such emotions. Anyway, 8 Legs to Love is cute, charming, and a lot of fun. The second half gets tough, relatively, but 8 Legs to Love is a pure high-score pursuit, like an arcade game without a lose state. As a result, the experience never feels cruel or punishing. Those who want something easy and simple can just play through the stages, and those who want challenge can try to get high scores or not let a single bug escape or something. The intuitive mechanics and cute simple graphics carry the unusual theme through all the way. The minimalistic use of sound only for movement harkens back to arcade classics like Dig Dug. Plus, the developer's classy enough to thank you for playing. You're welcome, Bridges. Bridges? Wait, Bridges? With a name like that, no wonder the bridge stage marked a transitional point. Next time on Pico-8 Adventures, we'll die alone in a harsh, frozen wilderness.